my way down the official along the official scenarios. I think part three is the next one I've got to do, and then we've got to do the other three parts to go back down the hill. Ripku, I've got no idea. I didn't even realise that had happened, actually. Right, Western Pacific 3rd Subdivision Dispatch. Good morning. The eastbound is coming around the curve now. Once he's here, you may proceed. Things are pretty busy, but you're clear for a while. Look at the view out of that window. OMG. Now, this train is really, really bizarre. So we've got a Burlington Northern. We've got a Western Pacific. We've got a Great Northern F7B unit. I've got Western Pacific GP9, and then we've got another couple of Burlingtons. This is an F40. There. Total mixed bag train, this is. So we've got Western Pacific unit train coming up the hill. Not a unit train, we've got tanks followed by boxes. Digris, DLC, downloadable content. Things that you can download and install into the game, like locos, routes, such. Velociforce, why can't you buy routes like Mirai's Pass? Again, it's down to licensing. The BNSF license is only available to sell products in America. It's not. We haven't got a license that allows Dovetail haven't got a license that allows to sell BNSF branded products in outside of America. So that's why. Axig says it's called an inside gateway train. They often had these pretty wacky lash-ups. I think it's awesome. But yeah, the BNSF SD40-2 is 44AC. You may have picked them up before the licensing thing came in. Or you may have them through a way that still works. In which case, I wouldn't shout too loud about it. So all of the wagons in the United States are apparently on this train. Wow, I called it the United States. What do you call it, French Stalin? Have we got any more scenario creations planned to do? Like, do you mean actually making a scenario? Right, so we're on our way down the grade now. This route is just non-stop gorgeousness. Oh, need to get them brakes on now. Oh, I've got dynamics now. Bit of dynamics just to keep it in check. We're speeding up a little bit, but about the Shanghai Maglev. I think pretty much you get what it says on the tin. I think some people have been expecting it to be something it isn't. Oops, a tiny change on the brakes and all of a sudden we're speeding. Get back and watch what we're doing, shall we? So what's our plan here? Go via, stop at Po, 19 miles. dynamics have gone off. Oh, probably because of the rail driver. Jamie, you want my hauling? Let's have a look. Boxcars. Just want to check that signal. We're good, we've got green. Excellent. Right, so we've got boxcars. Piggybacks. More boxcars. Centre beams, more boxcars, these boxcars or reefers, they're boxcars, more boxcars, got the Great Northern pack in here now as well, got some Logons, tanks, more boxes. Two-bay hopper on its own. Some steel in a Logon, some high gondolas. Three-bay by the looks of it. More boxes, more hoppers. More boxes, more boxes. More boxes. Oh my word, all the rest of the wagons from the US are here. More tanks, piggybacks, centre beams. Boxes. Oh, and a caboose. See what we're doing. We're going a bit slow here. That's because we've leveled out. Right, let's take the dynamics off. That's it, speeding up again now. The host, Neil. Just love this room, it's stunning. Put a bit of power on, we're still going down, but only gently, and apparently the wagon, those freight cars need a little bit of encouragement. Stunning, isn't it, DeGrist? It really is beautiful, this room. Tony, if you go onto Twitch in your own, because everyone's got their own channel on Twitch, you go into your own channel's chat and just type /host/ and the person you want to host, then it will do it for you. Thank you. Agent Smith, welcome. Poxon One, thank you for the host, much appreciated. If you haven't pressed follow yet, now's a good time. Cheers, Vince Starling. Thanks for joining. A little bit of dynamic brake. You know all the difference. We're speeding back up again now. Alright, no problem, Dean. What's your special news? Off. Trolling the rail driver. Oh, well done, Dean. That's fabulous news. Velociforce, it really, if you're looking at buying a route, it really depends on what you're interested in and what you've already got. Break on here. Daniel Kind of America, any news on the multi levels? I haven't got any news, no. I'm not really part of the retail side of things, so I've had to barely even part of the TS1 side of things anymore, so I find out about things probably a little bit after you, the number of times that you guys tell me what's been said. Yeah, Axie Gnettons, this route really is, it's a work of art, isn't it? The guys have, the team has really excelled themselves for this one. Ben Gaming 2001, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. Gav, once Bristol Cardiff comes out, I'm sure I will have a look. Stuck between Feather River Canyon and West Palm Beach, to be honest. Out of the two, personally, I'd probably go for Feather River Canyon because I like the scenery. I quite like the challenge of coming down the hills in the freight trains. If you want passenger stuff as well, then you might prefer the Miami one because that's got the Amtrak trains running up and down it. But it's a relatively flat route, so that it's less of that kind of a journey. So really, it depends what you prefer. I'm still the man when it comes to all things tea and EDG. You'd think so, wouldn't you? Except the last 3 or 4 days I've had coffee. Mostly because I drink so much tea of an evening on the show that I feel like I need a break when I'm at work. Cheers, Tyrant. I'll leave the dynamic brakes on with the lever, that way they won't reset themselves to off. That makes life very difficult. Ooh, look at this bridge. Look at this. Trees, stop trolling me. Right. What's the sleeper that goes up to Scotland? The Caledonian. Hey, dog. Steepest grade in Feather River. I don't know, actually. Don't know what the rolling grade is. Yeah, Lord BT50, I really need to go and look through my latest screenshots and put them in the... put a new set in the rotation. About feeling small in amongst all of this lot. How high that goes. Track 1 South, got a Western Pacific F7, yeah, it's Western Pacific's F7. Yeah, absolutely, Axie. Congrats to you and to your cousin. Very happy. Thank you. green light. Going to Pulga, track 2 north, 7.3 miles. It's a very un-American caboose. It was definitely a 100% authentic caboose. The only problem with all these trees is they're always getting in the way. I want a nuke trees button. They really stand up to a close look though, don't they? They're really nice trees. Let's see how that does. A little while before the train gets here. Meanwhile, we can sit and watch Track Simulator. Cue elevator music. Sit in the cab for a bit, we're going through a tunnel in a minute. Let's check that dynamic brake out. Slow down too much now. Tony P111, when is my 24 hour stream? April the 9th and April the 10th, did it? Oh, it's Saturday on Sunday. Let me have a look. Yeah, the 9th and 10th of April. Get through this little tunnel, me. I certainly will. In fact, it's only a short tunnel. Why don't I just pop out the other side? SD40 U30B. F7B, Great Northern, Western Pacific GP9, Burlington Northern GP38, and a Burlington Northern F40. Check me out! Cheers, Axeek. Thanks for the scenario. Thoroughly enjoying it. Philosophers, do I play any other games? What other games do I play other than Train Simulator? So I've got Bus Simulator 16, Elite, on the Xbox I've got Halo 5. I don't play lots of games at the moment. I mostly play Train Sim. I'm kind of either working or streaming or doing non-computer things. Flight sim occasionally. I don't play as much as I'd like, though. I need to fix that. There's none of this is on stream. The only thing I think stream is Minecraft and Train Sim. What else is there? Truck Sim, apparently. No, occasionally I play Euro Truck Sim. I haven't got American Truck Sim. I bought American Truck Sim for my son, and I watched him play it a little bit. I've watched a couple of streamers play it, but it's not different enough to make me want to buy it over a Euro Truck Sim. I might pick it up later on when there's more states in there. Whereas Bus Simulator 16 is, I'm really enjoying that actually. Mr. Steelman, do any idea when the next sale is? No, and I even if I do know them, I can't talk about anything that hasn't already been announced, so I'm the wrong place to come to for any sneaky peek information, unless I'm on the official stream. No, not a problem at all, Mr. Steelman, not a problem at all. Tree's in just the wrong place. Yeah, the J3 Cub Moggy is lovely, isn't it? The A2A one. That seems to have calmed down a lot. Well, we've only got 83 people on the stream at the moment. And it's just about midnight in the UK, so I think everyone's getting a bit sleepy. Certainly UK people. Degris has been playing with Flight Sim since it began. My first Flight Sim was FS4. Thing fit onto a 360k floppy disk. realistic soft body physics at a key one of crash trains. Favourite US route? I mean, this would have to be one of them these days, I think. Donner Pass is another favourite route. Once you get the Google map working, how do you put it in game? You can't. What you need to do is run the game as a borderless windowed mode, and then the map will sit on top of it, if I understand it correctly. I mean, I always run the game borderless windowed anyway. It looks full screen, but it plays nicely with everything else. Dynamics. Oops, I need to change it back to the right speedometer. There you go. Now it's the right speedometer. You're on borderless window, it's all squished. Well, that's interesting. Good night, GWR King Class. I missed a follow! No! That's bad form. Big Trucks 21, thank you for the follow. Fear the GPS unit in the car. Well, you know, if you don't want to do it properly. Yeah, I need. What I'm going to try to do is make it to where I can do some different train things, because you can add multiple of them on Twitch alerts, so that it picks a random one each time. It's on the to-do list. The only way I'm ever going to get anything done is to not stream. Only do DTM streams for a few weeks. I'm going to see what I can get done this weekend. I've got to get back, I've got to get the YouTube problem fixed. I've got so many videos now. They all need thumbnails. Half of them don't have screenshots to get the thumbnails from, so I've got to load them all back up again. ...1.4 miles to Pulgar. Twitch plays on while you do other stuff. Well, that was a thought I had one evening. But then I quite like watching and commenting, and I'd never get any work done. Tony P111, there is a map. I've got my own mapping system, but there is a there is one that Hopeless Hyena has developed, and I can't remember the command line I got. There you go, live maps. There you go. That'll tell you how to. No, it's not live map. That's not what I miss. Really, what I suspect is that you typed it and just happened to come up with that message. Follow map, there you go. GG. Stuff there. There we go, Pulga Track 2 North. How have I failed? Dave, how have I failed? What have I done now? Going past another heck. A darn. That's it, it's a darn, that's what we called it. I'm not calling the other thing. Wow, every one of these passing points has got a meet. Another unusual train. My own commands, Dave. No, I didn't add that one. Someone else added that one. All of a sudden, we're going down a hill. It's back on the dynamics, put a bit of air in the system. Ho, track 2 south in 5 miles for our finish. What program do you use for your videos? I use OBS for basic stuff, which is what I'm streaming with. So as I'm streaming here, it's being recorded by Twitch, and then what I do is I go onto Twitch, do a thing, and then shoot it straight over. For any videos that I actually create myself, I'm using the one on Steam, Sony Movie Studio, I think it is. It's about 30 quid. Does the job really well, actually. No, it's not Vegas, but then it costs 300. Either. Well, I've got tons of stuff sitting in the backlog on YouTube that I've highlighted and pushed up to YouTube, so I don't think I've lost anything yet. Megato, yes, Dovetail produced the Mirai's Pass route. You're going into the hole of Poe for a meet with another eastbound. See it coming across down there. I haven't highlighted the Nebworth War VOD yet, the Battle of Nebworth. Mike K, not so much cups of tea. Well, I've had three. I figured that's probably enough. And a bottle of water. Lovely view where you can see the train winding its way around all the way back there. Alright, I'm going to kill the dynamics at the moment. The grade has changed, we're only on a 0.5% grade now. Tyson is cool, the game crashed, it does sometimes because of the memory situation. I think there might be a bad memory stick in this machine. Diet Coke tonight. No, I don't really drink Diet Coke. I used to, when I started streaming, I had a fridge full of Diet Coke, and I realised that I'd got myself, that was going to be a really bad habit. So I thought I would break that. And so what I did is I went and bought a ton of water bottles. Now I have water or tea. Memory stick being naughty. I don't know what you mean, Muggy. Certainly will, Mekgato. Thanks for that. Glad you're enjoying it. But that looks interesting. Come over here. And then look around and zoom in. Oh, yeah. If I can get these trees out of the way, we'll be in good shape. Oh, bad memory stick, yeah, probably. If you have, guys aren't aware already, by the way, all of the screenshots I take get uploaded to Flickr. I've got an account on Flickr. You'll see it up there in the thing that's flashing away up there, like it says find us on Twitter. There's another one that says find us on Flickr, I think. So just, you can have a look there. And then if you use something like John's background switcher, you can point it to my Flickr account, and then you can make it to where the backgrounds of your desktops, with hand wavy motions as well, apparently. The backgrounds of your desktop actually can change to the stuff that's in the Flickr, which is it's what I use at work, so I've got different train screenshots on my machine at work, which is quite cool actually. They usually get people asking questions about them when they walk past the machine. I think I've got something like 3,000 screenshots up there now. Where can you get a train simulator, Timmer? You can get that on Steam. Steampowered.com. Look for Train Simulator by Dovetail Games. Tyson is cool. What happened to... in fact, a couple of them are supposed to be right off. Nice one. What happened to the custom pictures on the slideshow? Basically, because of the whole branding and licensing thing, I don't play anything that's not on Steam because of one of the reasons is branding and licensing. The problem that I've got is the screenshots, as it turns out, can't be like that either. And so I have to have only licensed stuff. I can't guarantee that anything that's... It would take too long to go through the things, the screenshots people send, to completely be assured that there's nothing in there that I'm going to get in trouble for. And therefore, rather than promise to put screenshots up and fail, I'm just not promising to put screenshots up. Cattle sitting on the tracks, Digrist. Yeah, that was on the that was on last night's stream. Not last night's, Tuesday's stream. That was quite neatly done. 2 miles to Poe, track 2 south. SD40-2, thanks for following, much appreciated. If there's anything you'd like to see, then shout and do my best. Got a 20 limit coming up ahead here. Philosophers, this scenario is only an hour. I know it seems like a long scenario, but it's only an hour. People keep suggesting 2 hours and 3 hour long scenarios. But basically, once you get anywhere near an hour, everyone starts getting itchy and want to move on. Got the secondary signal there. I'm glad you've enjoyed it, Tony. We've got a little bit to do after this. We're going to do a little bit of train spotting for 15 minutes before we finish off. Well, I mean, 35 minutes is a really good length, actually. It's enough to feel that you've actually done something, but not so much that you wonder when to end. That's really good, Axis. It's notice what you said about scenario length to be true. Now you've shortened your scenarios, they start performing so much better. You mean you're getting more positive reviews and things, Axis? That's very interesting. I'm really glad you're seeing that. get this room. It's well worth it, it's a really good room. Hey Jesse James, welcome back. Right, we've got the stopping point and a red signal coming up ahead. Yeah, I said the guy that made the 3 hours an hour. I know I did, didn't I? I keep going on to everybody else about making short scenarios, and my only real submission to work job is a 3-hour scenario on Donna Pass. It's a GG, man, GG. Never mind. What I should do is rewrite it as 3 bits. Three shorter scenarios. Essentially it's a bunch of switching, then a journey to along the line, and then a bunch of switching. Alright, we're coming up on Poe Track 2 South now. I'm sorry, but I'm just going to let the train stop where it stops. Need a 48-hour stream? Nah, 24 hours is enough, mate. 24 hours is definitely enough. On Friday, 24 hours. Good job, you have a bit of time, so why not have some coffee while you wait? Superb! Great scenario, Agsig. Really enjoyed that one. Really enjoyed it. Right. Next is our last scenario. We're going to do a little bit of train spotting on the Liverpool-Manchester route. Let me just go and dig that one.